Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. I welcome you on Sanjay Gupta Tech School. In this video, I am going to explain how you can implement these three methods with the help of C language. So first is delete first, second is delete last, and third is delete after. And we are going to apply these delete operations on single linked list. So if you want to watch how we can implement their algorithms, so you can find link of that playlist in the description of this video. But in this video, I will be telling you how you can write functions. Those are implemented in C language related to these three operations, right? So first I am picking delete first. So let's focus on this single linked list. Let's say this linked list is already created and we want to delete its first node. So address of first node, base address is 1001, which is stored in start pointer. Then this node link part is having address of second node. Second node link part is having address of third node. So this way we create linkages. And if you want to know how we can create linkages, so that video is also available in that playlist. So all the links are available in the description of this video. So you can go and watch. So now let's implement delete first. So this is return type. Then name of function is delete first, and it will be receiving a pointer in start. So through main function, this delete first function will be called, and main function will be passing address of first node that is available in the linked list, and that address is stored in this start pointer. So this start pointer will be passed through main function, and that will be received into this pointer, right? Now I am going to declare one more pointer, struct node pointer p. Now I am going to check if start double equals to null. So why I am checking this? Because if linked list is not having any particular node, so it means your linked list is empty. So that needs to be checked. So if start is equals to null, so in that case we can print underflow. It means linked list is not having any particular node. So you can print the message as per your requirement. So underflow means that we don't have anything to delete, and return. So return will terminate execution of this method or function. So if start is equals to null, it means there is no node available in the linked list and we cannot delete it. If this condition is false, like this is the scenario, linked list is having three nodes and we need to delete this particular node, first node, right? So what we need to do? We need to remove this from this linked list. So right now this first node address is available to start. If we try to delete this node, so it means this will become first node. So this node's base address, that is 2001, should be available into start. But right now it is available into this position. So this is basically link of first node. And first node address is available into start. So what we can do? P equals to start. So P is a pointer which will have address of first node, that is 1001. Now I can type start equals to start link. So start is basically of type structure. So whenever we access member of structure through pointer, then we need to use this arrow notation. So this you can create by hyphen and greater than sign. So start is having 1001, its link is having 2001. So that will go into start. So new value of start will be 2001. So here you can see 2001, it means start is now pointing to this node. So this became first node, this became second node, and this is not part of this linked list. Its address is available to this P pointer. Now, if you want to free this memory so that any other program can utilize this memory, so for that purpose, you can write free P. And you can return start, because in this function we modified the address which is stored in the start. So we need to return this so that it can be received by the main function. And now I am going to do this. So this way I implemented first logic, which is based on delete first. So we deleted first node from the linked list with help of this C function, right? So I hope you understood this. Now I am going to explain delete last logic. So first I am going to erase this one, then I will be explaining delete last. So now I am going to explain how we can write a function for delete last. So delete last means we need to delete this node from the linked list. So there can be two scenarios. First, like we are going to delete the node which is the only node in the linked list. Like you are going to perform delete last operation, but your linked list is having only one node, right? And second scenario is your linked list is having more than one node, and you need to traverse each and every node, and you need to move to last location, and last node will be deleted, right? So we will cover both the scenarios. So now I am going to write the method. So return type will be struct node pointer, then delete last name of function, then it will receive address of first node into this start pointer. So this function will also be called from main function. Main function will be passing base address of the first node. So in main function we also have start pointer, so that will be passing the address of first node, and that is received into this pointer. Now I'm going to create two more pointers. So first is pre-PTR and second one is PTR, right? Now if start is null, so this is the case, your linked list is already empty, it is not having any particular node. So this condition you also check in case of delete first. So here you can print address loop. And return. So return will terminate this execution of this function. So that's why I mentioned this. So this is the scenario where linked list is empty. So we already checked this. Now, if linked list is not empty, it means now we need to check whether we have only one node in the linked list or we have more than one node in the linked list, right? So, for example, first I am assigning start into PTR. Now I am applying if condition. Through if I am checking PTR link double equals to none. So this is the case which says linked list is having only one node. So for example, I am modifying this linked list. So let's say this is start and this is first node whose base address is 1001, it is stored here 10 and none. So this is our linked list which is having only one node, and we are going to delete this one. So start is assigned into PTR. So PTR will be pointing to this node. Now we are checking PTR link. So PTR is 1001, its link is null. So this condition is true. It means the node which we are going to delete is the only node in the linked list. It means now we can assign null into start, because if we delete this node, it means now linked list will not be having any particular node. So its start will be equals to null, and after completion of this code we are going to return the start, so that actual linked list that is available in the main function will be modified. If this condition is false, it means this is the scenario. Linked list is having more than one node, right? So if it is false, it means PTR link is not null. So I am erasing this from here. This we already covered. Now we are going to cover this scenario. So linked list is having three nodes. PTR is pointing to the first node. Now we need to iterate a loop so that we can move to the last node, right? So here I am checking while PTR link not equals to null. So if PTR link is not equals to null, then we need to move to Next node. So right now PTR is here. In second rotation, PTR will move to here. Then PTR will be here, and then PTR link is null, so it will be stopped. Now what we need to do? We need to assign null at this location because we are going to delete this node. So we need one more pointer, that is pre-PTR. So when PTR will be pointing to the last node, then in that case pre-PTR will be pointing to this node. So right now PTR is pointing to first node. Its length is not equal to null. So condition is true. So PTR will be pointing to second node. So when PTR will be pointing to second node, so pre-PTR should point to this node. So how you can achieve this? So you can assign PTR into pre-PTR. So PTR is 1001. Let's say this is pre-PTR. So now PTR is assigning its value into pre-PTR. So it will be having 1001 and PTR equals to PTR link. So this will be the case. So PTR link. So PTR is 1001, its link is 2001. So now here 2001 will be available. And you can close this. Now PTR is pointing to 2001 and pre-PTR is pointing to 1001. So pre-PTR is on first node, PTR is on second node. Now check this condition, PTR link. So PTR is 2001, its link is 3001, which is not equal to null. So PTR will assign its value to pre-PTR. So it will become 2001 and PTR link, it is 3001, that will come here. So right now PTR is pointing to this and pre-PTR is pointing to this. So PTR link, so PTR is 3000, its link is none, so it means this loop will be terminated. So right now we have both the pointers. The node which we are going to delete is pointed by PTR and its previous node is pointed by pre-PTR. So now what we can do? We can simply assign null to this location. And this location we can access to pre-PTR. So after completion of this loop, you can type pre-PTR link equals to null. So it means here null will be assigned. So if this node is having null, it means this node is automatically deleted from the linked list. And now if you want to delete that node actually, so after this else, so if else both are completed, so after that you can write pre-PTR. So PTR will be pointing to a particular node. So in that case, if this condition is true, in that case PTR will be pointing to the only node that is available in the linked list, and in else case PTR will be pointing to the last node that is available in the linked list. So in both the cases you are going to free the PTR, and at last you can write return start. So if this is the case, then start will be changing, so we need to return this. And if this is the case, then start is not changing, then also we can return this, right? Or you can write this return statement here also. And this is completed, so I am marking it as closed. So this way I explained you second method, that is delete class. So in delete class we have two logics. First one is covering when linked list is having only one node, and second is covering when linked list is having more than one nodes. So this way, this is the C function, or you can say delete last algorithm is implemented by C language. So I hope you understood how this code is working, and now you can implement this code into your compiler so that you can execute it. But don't forget, you need to call this delete last function to main function. Now you might be thinking, like, can you explain or can you implement this code on IDE or any compiler so that we can view how we can call this method in main function or other methods. So for that purpose, you can go to description of this video. You will find link of a playlist like DSA code implementation using IDE with the help of C language. So if you open that playlist, so you will find a video related to code implementation of linked list. So where I have implemented insertion, deletion, traverse, searching, sorting, all the tools will be available in a single program. So you can watch and you can view like how we can manage the code of single linked list together in a same program, right? So now we covered delete last. So next is delete after. So in case of delete after, we are going to delete a particular node from the middle of the link, right? So after explaining this, now I'm going to erase this so that we can discuss delete after. So now I'm going to explain how you can write the code for delete after operation. So in case of delete after, you need to specify which node you are going to delete. So let's say I'm passing position as 2. So it means I am going to delete the node which is on third location or third position. So delete after. So I am saying position is 2. You need to delete the node which is after second position. So second position is this. So we are going to delete this node. So this way the code will be working. And again, if you want to watch the algorithm related to delete after, so that link is available in the description. So you can go through and watch that. So now, in this case, return time will be void because we are not going to change the start, and we already know there are a lot of nodes available in the linked list, and we are going to delete any middle node. So void delete after, then struct node pointer start and integer position, right? Now this start will be having address of first node that will be provided by main function, and position will be having the value after which node will be deleted. So if position is 2, it means we are going to delete third node. If position is 10, it means we need to delete the 11th node, right? So now I am creating one pointer that is ptr, right? Then integer I. Now I am iterating the loop. So I is 1 and ptr equals to start. So these two are initialization statements. Then condition is I less than position. So if I is less than position, then this loop will repeat, otherwise it will be done. Then I plus plus comma ptr equals to ptr link. So I will be incremented by 1 and ptr will be pointed to next location or next node. Now if ptr is null, so let's say position is 4. Position is 4 and we are moving from one node to another. So there will be a scenario when ptr will be equals to null. It means we need to print a message: node does not exist. So the position you specified that is not available, it means we cannot perform deletion operation, and you can write return. Otherwise, this loop will execute properly and it will be terminated naturally, and your ptr will be pointing to that location after which or you can say if ptr is pointing to second node, so it means we are going to delete the third, right? So let's iterate this loop. Position value is 2, I is 1, ptr will be pointing to start. So let's say this is ptr, it will be adding 1001. Now check the condition I less than position, so it is true because I is 1 and position is 2. Then ptr double equals to none, so it is false. Then I will be incremented, so I is 2 and ptr will move to ptr length. So ptr is 1001, its length is 2001. So ptr will be pointing to 2000, this location. So right now I is 2, position is 2, so this loop will be terminated, right? So in our case, ptr is pointing to second node and we are going to delete this third node. So its link is having 3001. So in previous example in daily class I mentioned null here, so I am erasing that and assigning 3001, which is the address of this node, and it will be stored here. So now PTR is on second node and we are going to delete third node. Again, let's say you iterated this loop and PTR was not equals to null. This loop got terminated, and in case your PTR is pointing to last one. For example, PTR is pointing to last one. So you entered position as 3, right? So PTR was not equals to null and PTR is pointing to this location. But after this node, any other node is not available. It means delete after cannot apply it, because you are on PTR, you are on third node, PTR is on third node, but after that no node is available. So in that case, you can check this condition. If PTR link is null, so you entered by mistake last position. You entered by mistake last position or the position of last node. So it means after that node, no node is available. It means delete after cannot be applied. So here you can write print. So you can frame a particular message. So here you can print no node is there for deletion, right? And return. So this you also need to take care of, right? But in our case, PTR is pointing to this, and PTR link is not null, so this will be false because PTR link is 3001. Now what we need to do? We need to assign this null here so that this node will be deleted, right? So let's say we have one more node, so it is 3001. We have one more node, that is 4001.40 and null, and its address is 4001 link one. So now we are on second position, we are going to delete third node, right? So what we need to do, this node will be deleted, this node will be deleted, so this node's address should be here. It means second node link part will be having address of fourth node, then only this node will be deleted. But this node 3001 is having address of fourth node, so from here we need to assign this location to here, right? So how we can do that? So you need to write PTR start. So PTR is pointing to that location. So you can write PTR start. So we need to assign value here. So sorry. PTR link, not start. We need to assign value here. So this is PTR link. So value will be assigned here. And from where? Here. Right? So that location is PTR link. So this statement you need to write. So now PTR is 2001. PTR is on 2001. What is its link? That is 3001. So PTR will be going to 3001, which is this, and its link is 4001. So by this, what we are getting? 4001, and that will be assigning to PTR link. So PTR link is now 4000, right? So it means this is disconnected and it is pointing to this location. So this is first node now, this is second node, and this is pointing to this third node, and it is deleted. Now we need to delete it physically so that this memory can be utilized by any other program. But here you can see, now we cannot access 3000 from anywhere, because 3000 was written here and we erased that and we assigned this value from here to here. Now before executing this statement, earlier here was 3000, that's why it was linking to this and it was linking to this. So before executing this, you need to use one more pointer, let's say T, and inside T you can assign PTR link. So this is T pointer, it will be having 3000, that is PTR link. And now you can execute this. So PTR link will be having this 4000. So it is 8 now. So these are just connected. So this node's address is available to T, and here you can write free and close this function. So this way, this delete after operation will be performed. So this way, I explained you all three logics. First was delete first, second was delete last, and third is delete after. So this way, I hope you understood how we can implement all three functions with the help of C language. Now, if you want to watch their algorithm or their implementation with the help of IDE, that is explaining all the function implementation together. So you can go to description of this video. You will find links of playlist. And while playing that playlist, you need to search the related video and you can watch the complete program or complete algorithm. So I hope you understood whatever I explained in this.